Hello everyone, and welcome to one of the most haunted sites on the Eastern Seaboard, the Peyton Randolph House. This house was built in 1715 and occupied by a very well-known Virginian, Sir John Randolph, and later passed on to his son, Peyton Randolph, and Betty Randolph. But where does all of this strange paranormal activity come from? Well, this is one of the sites that we can't really pinpoint a specific thing. Several things have happened. In fact, during the Civil War, the governor of Williamsburg at the time sent out a proclamation that said any slave that decided to abandon their slave owner and join the British forces would become free. So what would any slave do at the sound of freedom? They would run away. I know I would. That's exactly what Betty Randolph's personal slave did. She ran away. Her name was Eve, and at the end of the Civil War, unfortunately, for whatever reason, they couldn't keep their promise. So the slaves were sent back to their slave owners and treated even more poorly. At the death of Betty Randolph, Eve faced more heartache when she was forced to live separately from her son because she was sold back into slavery. So Eve lived a pretty rough couple of years. Oh, well, in fact, her whole life. And so it's said that upon her departure, she placed a curse upon the Peyton Randolph House. Now, could this be why over 24 people have lost their lives on this ground? We're not really sure, because even in the 1930s, on the eastern side of the home, there were excavations done and Indian grave sites were found. So that means even before 1715, there was so much history here with the Indians. The Indians had sacred grounds. They did sacred rituals when they buried their loved ones. And so when the eastern side of the house was excavated, those sites were found. So that means that these spirits may have been disturbed upon the building of this house and upon the building of all of these other homes that we've seen today. So what does that mean? Does that mean that some Indian spirits have also occupied the grounds? In 1824, the French general Marquis de Lafayette visited the Peyton Randolph House. He said that it was an honor to come into the home of Peyton Randolph and stay there. But he said upon entering the home, he felt a nudging, probably to say, you might not want to be here, sort of pushing him back. And even as he slept, he said he did not get much rest because he heard the voices of children. The voices of children. Can you imagine staying somewhere and being awakened by voices of children when there are no children to be found? Even more recently, in the 1960s, when this home was used as a dormitory for the College of William and Mary, a woman is said to have been awakened by someone pulling at her while she was sleeping. And I don't know about you, but if someone starts pulling at me while I'm sleeping and I can't see them, I'm getting out of there. And that's exactly what she did. She didn't even come back for her belongings. The security guard, which you can find this story on the website and the blogs and video footage of it, the security guard got locked in the basement. He said it felt like someone was shackling his ankles and holding him there and not letting him leave. So how do we explain all of this? It's almost unexplainable, but those are the two happenings that we have as to why these events are happening. Now, you can look on our blog, as I stated, on the website, and you can read several other firsthand accounts of things that happened. One of the most interesting and most intriguing to me is the one where a lady passed away and the fire alarm went off several days later. Security, first responders, they didn't have access to the home, so they had to break in through a window. And what they found was almost amazing. And it's weird to use that word amazing, but they found a fire extinguisher in the middle of the room and the fire retardant all over, just blanketed perfectly. No footprints, no pin in the fire extinguisher. And they said when they walked in and they picked up the fire extinguisher, there was a perfect circle, which means that someone had to place it there. Someone had to pull the pin, but where are the footprints? Where are the handprints? No one knows. It's one of my favorite stories, and I haven't experienced a lot of paranormal activity here. But I can only believe that something is here among us right now. Something is telling us to keep it moving.